Hello, my name is Sami, I'm Software Engineering Manager at MentorMate, and today I'm going to talk about mobile applications and what are the most popular tools you could use in order to make ones. The technologies I'm going to focus on are native applications, React Native, Flutter, and Kotlin Multiplatform for mobile. Let's start with native applications. This is the most common way you could use in order to make mobile applications, and in general it means that you will be using the official tools of Google and Apple. The main advantage of this approach is that you have access to all the bells and whistles of Android and iOS, but it has the disadvantage of being very costly. Using native applications is a very safe bet, and developers could implement very well polished applications that way. Let's compare this to React Native. React Native is a cross-platform development tool. That means that you'll be able to reuse a lot of your code across Android and iOS. As a result, the development cycle is usually very fast. Another advantage of React Native is that it's based on web development tools, so if you know web development, you might have easy time learning it. There are a few disadvantages though. In general, you might have to wait a bit in order to access the latest features of Android and iOS, and accessing device sensors like Bluetooth might be a bit difficult. Flutter is another cross-platform development tool, but it has a few differences. It focuses more on UI and UX, so if you want to implement an application focusing on its design, like a portfolio application for example, it might be a good choice for you. The main disadvantage in comparison to React Native is that Flutter is a bit more difficult to learn. Last but not least, let's focus on Kotlin Multiplatform for mobile. That's another cross-platform development tool, but it's the exact opposite of Flutter. Its UI capabilities are a bit lacking, but its ability to share business logic code across Android and iOS is very, very good. This can be very useful for applications that want to behave exactly the same way across platforms. Examples of such applications are usually ones working in heavily regulated fields like healthcare and finance. KMM shares the same disadvantage as Flutter though. Being less popular means that there are fewer learning resources, and in general, getting into it might be a bit more difficult. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it was helpful to you. If you are curious about anything else, feel free to reach out to us. Have a nice day!